Thank you very much. I'm going to read from a little pamphlet that I produced with Sheila Solway called Mountain Snow, and it's printed on a risograph machine, which is a little bit like a photocopier. Myself and Sheila produced it as part of a Bodleian Library workshop back at the end of last month. And it has some illustrations in it that on the spur of the moment I cut out of the catalogue of a well-known London antiquarian bookseller, which shall remain nameless. I didn't plagiarise the original 16th century books themselves, but you can see these little sort of roundels. I caused so much chaos when I went into this antiquarian bookshop that they've been sending me their catalogue ever since. When I had an eye operation about 2 years ago, I felt that maybe if it went wrong, I wouldn't get to look at any 12th century manuscripts again. So I better go and have a look. And I vividly remember, wandering in and, taking a book off the shelf and looking and seeing Caxton's sort of colophon, and then I thought, oh, it's all right, it's Wynkyn de Worde. He's just using his master's little colophon, but yeah, I mean, it was only about £55,000. I put it back quickly as the alarms.
After you cut it out?
But I mean, it was just sort of, I don't know whether it was lying on the floor or where it was, but I mean, I must apologise to them for plagiarising their lovely catalogue. So, I'll get to the point. This is Mountain Snow. It's adapted from the medieval Welsh Airy Minid stanzas. That's a 12th century poem, a Welsh poem about every stanza of the poem begins with the words Airy Minid, which apparently means mountain snow. So here we go, mountain snow. Mountain snow, white waters dance, branches slap, the winds advance, lovers too often miss their chance. Mountain snow, the wind is vicious, dock leaves rock, a moon so gibbous, every fool must grow litigious. Mountain snow, hens shift red feet, where water prattles, it's not deep. Long words seldom earn their mountain snow, there's too much white. Hear how the raven shakes the night. Abandon sleep, get up and write.
Yes.
And I now have two new poems to read. And I shall try to unfold them from the chaos in which they lurk. And I hope I've got them in the right order, although it can be... Is it going to tear? Good Lord. This poem is called Things the Vicar Said. Now...
Which vicar?
It's a sort of composite amalgam vicar made up of all the vicars I have known. Oh. Some of them, at any rate. And I had I don't know whether to call it a revelation or not. I had a thought the other day when I thought of all of the very strange things that clergymen and indeed women have said to me over the years.
That was an epiphany.
It was. And I thought that maybe I could put some of these into a poem. And when I started to think of it, I thought, goodness, there's a lot of material here. But I also, I suppose it's a sort of homage to Christopher Smart, who wrote that lovely poem, For I Will Consider My Cat Geoffrey. I think that somehow Christopher Smart must have been working in the back of my mind at the same time, as well as all the strange things the vicar said. This is called Things the Vicar Said. That angels have six wings. That when young, he wanted to nail himself to the west door. That it was time to leave the YMCA when the jam and Marmite coalesced. That he no longer believed that there is nothing more splendid than the bathroom at a papal villa. That we should pray for spiders, for the sins of the church, for everything that creeps. this is called In the Woods, and I was listening to it a couple of days ago. I suppose it was Radio 4 informed me that it was the autumn equinox, and they had some lovely poems. And there was a very fine poet who wrote about her local wood. And I thought that I would try to write about the wood near Headington in Oxford that I regularly walk through, and to try to write about how it inspired me. And the wood is both a beautiful place, but it's a place of sort of suffering and deprivation, and I thought of all of the dealers that I see bicycling swiftly through my wood, and I greet them and they're very friendly, and all of the other people in the wood. So there was something about my local wood that wasn't perhaps the romantic image of the wood with a capital R. When I got to the end of my local wood the other day, there were some chaps there. And they hailed me, and I said, hello, and they said, jolly good show, and I said, absolutely, you know. So my walks through the wood, I pushed a gentleman in a wheelchair who accidentally got lost in the middle of the wood. After about 45 minutes, I sort of said, how did you even get here? And he wasn't sure. And I was really rather hoping that perhaps another kind soul would come along. that doesn't make it into the poem. That'll have to be another poem. But this is called In the Woods. There is a painted dragon in the woods. The hooded dealers pass him on their bikes, ferrying rock and skunk and other gear, only the birch knows why. There are violets in the woods, fragile as magenta dusk, when the trees clear their twilight lungs against the jittery sky. There are addicts in the woods, where out of it scents were with smoke. Soon firefighters will come, but woodland now slips and trips, loosens her oak wide grips.
Yes.
Thank you.